So we've just talked about this balance between speed and amount of air, and we also talked about support. Again, it's very quick and it's very simple, but don't be put off by the fact that it is simple. It does not have to be complicated. Now, using this technique as a part of sound development as well is very important, but also the technique of actually producing a sound. Let's go really to basics. A lot of problems among flute players is actually the placement of the flute. We tend to plonk it on our lip and just go, and there's your basic, what I would consider a bad sound. Spend some time in finding this, just the joint between the lip and the skin here. It will vary from person to person, but it's generally around here that we find this nice position. Now, again, I really don't deal in embouchures as such. I don't really talk too much about here, except to say the lips must go forward. It's as simple as that. And here's another very simple exercise to help us with this lips forward. In fact, I nicknamed it years ago goldfishing. It's just like a goldfish. It's like, if I can do mouth exercises. So combined with this good breath support, if you put the lips well forward and you blow, bingo, it's as simple as that. And I'm not using any tongue there, because sometimes when we use the tongue, it masks the support. So we really want to get speed of air, warm air from down here through this simple passage here. You can do it all over the flute, and it's an excellent step, second step of a warm-up.